Example, you remember. So I can start. That we seek a solution of Laplace's equation using cylindrical coordinates, not coordinates, using cylindrical harmonics. Harmonics meaning what we came up with when we were trying to come up with the solutions to the radio equation and the angular equation. These are the harmonic solutions we are talking about when we got a solution of phi phi and got the r r. These are what we are calling harmonic. The harmonics or cylindrical harmonics to satisfy the following boundary conditions. The following boundary conditions. One. The first condition is at great distances from the axis of the cylinder. Then we have that the potential tends to minus E naught x, which is equal to minus E naught cos r cos phi. And this is at great distances, as r tends to infinity. This is our equation. I don't remember exactly how many equations we are reaching. Or can we call it equation 1? For this example, we have to go and look for it. But what we are trying to talk about is we are having our cylinder, and these are the walls of the cylinder. Z, if you took the cylinder to be containing water, as you are filling up the water, gives you your Z. As you are having, so this is our, y, x, z, so let's assume it ends up there. If we are going to get any value, first of all, this cylinder grows big at the same time as we take this angle, if we took any place, like on the point of on the cylinder, so I'm going to take any point around there. I'm having the r, which would be the distance from z to that point. And if I take the this one down here, the projection of this r is this one here, and I still can either touch the cylinder, because this cylinder can bulge until it becomes, that's why R changes. And then we have in the angle such a plane sweeps to complete like this one now. If I turn it and make sure it gives a track. If I turn it proportionately, I'll turn it through horizontally, I'll be able to get a cylinder of that size as radius. And then this will be the angle times through, which is phi. We have the z here, and those are the three coordinates r, phi, z that we have. Now for any given point,
which we are looking at as so E naught. So what would be the x if you were to find the x? This is our R. So we want to get x in terms of R and phi. That's why we're having the x being the component of R along the x, which is R cos phi. That's why I have put this as minus E naught x, which is the same as minus E naught cos E naught R cos phi, for when you move away farther and farther away from this axis, because this is the z here is the axis. This is minus z, and depending on whether you want to see the rotation of the plane that way, or if it is to be this way, which is the same as this, or the other way. And so the farther you move away from this place, the center, the axis being a sphere, is where we are talking about R tending to infinity. Have you confirmed whether we had any other equation being 8, 7, blah blah? Was the previous equation called 8?
Yes.
Good. So let's move on, because we are taking the example to emphasize on our point. So the second boundary condition is to assume that assume the cylinder is halved. Assume the cylinder is halved. If it is halved, then on its sides, on the sides of the cylinder, we wouldn't have any potential. So for the case of the cylinder which we talked about, it's really as was given as A. So the potential at the surface, which would be really as A phi, all right? This would have been R phi, but R at the surface is A, would be equal to 0, because we have earthing. When you put an earthing on the sides of the of this cylinder, you make that that means that you have made it have potential on these sides B equal to 0. So we have two boundary conditions. Let's now see how they can help us to find the potential anywhere around this cylinder, or within the vicinity of this cylinder. So, examination of, or looking at examination of equations, A and N, show that this examination shows that k is equal to 1. Thus, we would have that V R phi is equal to A1 R to the 1 plus B over R into C1 cos phi plus B1 sin phi. And I can say this is now our equation. If we take this to be 9, this also is a condition, so we say this is 10, and then this will be our equation 11. And we can draw this scenario where we have the field lines in this direction. And then we get our serina. I will take the side of the serina. By take the serina is in the blackboard. So I can only draw a circle, which is on the cross section. It should be a serina. This looks like as if it is oval. So it should be purely a serina. It is of radius A, so I'll take this to be the center. This is A. If we took two points, one point being P prime, of course, that one would be, so this would be R minus phi, and the other point. Like its image on the other side is our P R positive, phi positive, and let's take this to be our X along which our field is acting. Or its point. And of course, we said that our serina surface is earthed. So I put the earth in here. And this is a serina of radius A. So we do the business now, that from symmetry, we have that V R theta, R phi, is equal to V R minus phi. The potential at this point, particular point, and the potential that on the other side, if this is the same serina. So for example, if I took a point around this region and I also take another around this whole part, okay, we should be able to have the same potential at that point. So but if we just took two particular points where you have the P R minus phi and of course P R phi, then we have, of course, the reason for that is because of the these quadrants as you are moving around the circumference, the cross-sectional area of the scene. So this is the potential at P is the same as the potential or as that at P prime. And this implies that if that is the case, then what changes here, if two of these are the same, and you instead have, or you substitute for phi and minus phi, and you equate these two equations, what happens? What is the relationship between sine theta and minus? Sine theta and sine minus theta, what is the difference between them, or the similarity? What is sine? Sine theta equals what, and what is sine minus theta? One is a half, another one is a negative half. On the both side? It's the same. Well, so the idea would be that our D1 would be equal to zero. Thus, V out of phi would be the same as A1 R plus B over R, and B1. And I think this one also would be B1. And this would be C1 plus phi. When you put substituting for minus phi and phi, when you get the two equations to fulfill this condition, you should be able to determine that D1 is equal to zero. So the other that means that this is our equation 12. So then I have that V as R tends to infinity, phi is equal to minus E naught R cos phi. And A1 R E nu C1 cos phi would be, this is algebra, I'm just doing some algebra, I shouldn't be doing this. But I'm just doing algebra. So since as R tends to infinity, you have this as that. So that means if I put in here for R, I would eliminate this term. This would, as R tends to infinity, it would become smaller and smaller and disappears. None. So that I would remain with A1R, C1 cos theta, cos phi equals to this value. For that boundary condition. And this would imply that C1 A1 would be equal to minus E, because the arrows would cancel, the phi cos phi would cancel. I remain with A1 C1 or C1 A1, whatever the case you want to call it, or which one you want to begin with, is equal to minus E0. We can call this one equation 13. For the condition of being around the potential being the same, being zero around the sides of the cylinder, because you are earthing it, then this tantamounts to the scenario that VAFI equals to zero. This would imply that we will get the, we put this and we utilize our equation 12. 12 is where? Is here. I feel like I want to doze on the board. I'll try to finish. I'll try to finish. Pardon? What happened to you? Me, I haven't slept comfortably. You, what? For you, what's your problem? You are really? I don't really know how far you slept. Me, I have. Oh, me, I have. So, for you, if you didn't have power, get up. So the with that condition, we have from equation 12 that 0 would be equal to A1A plus B1 over A, E, because that which of course also goes to zero. So I cannot be able to remain with
this and instead put my C, C1 and C1. I'm not sure whether that one is even important because the C1 appeared in both sides, it could have gone away. Isn't it? I said when I use this condition and utilize equation 12, then this is zero when I say VA5. So where there is R, I put A. And what would be left would be the C1. And I also felt like I shouldn't even hassle to write the C1 because it's going to also be divided by both sides. It would be zero over that and would have been.
I don't understand how you get to this.
All the constants are disappeared. What is zero divided by any number?
Zero.
Yeah, so divide both sides by cos 5. It will go, and even see what I see in a
constant.
I feel like even C1 is going, but there is a nice reason why it isn't going at this point. There is a nice reason we are not making it go because of being C1, A1 is going to negative now. So I beg to move. So this would imply that B1 C1 is equal to minus C1 A1 into A square. This is after multiplying by A plus, this is A square, and this would be B1 C1. You equal it to, you give a minus there, or you have B1 C1 equaling to positive E naught A square. Since I say this is equation 14, and I say since E naught or minus E naught is equal to well A1 C1 to C1 A1. Just to make your life uncomfortable. So that you don't take everything on a silver plate. Wait, which one is our equation 13? Yes, this one here. Now I can easily now move on that using equation 13 and 14, this and that, using equations 13 and 14, in equation 12, which is the solution of our potential, the equation giving us our potential yields or gives V alpha is equal to minus E naught into R minus A cubed over R cos 5. Therefore, we can get our potential due to this cylinder being the same as A squared over R minus R E naught cos 5. And now that you've got, now that we have got the potential, you can use it to find the electric field density. You can use it to find the charge density to measure that. This one here. Is what?
This square is
well, this one here is there's no way it can become a cube. Because we have the is emanating from here. Thanks. So we've gotten the potential of due to this cylinder. And as I've said, once you have the potential, you can use the relationship E is equal to minus grad V to get the electric field density. And you can use the what? To find the charge density and the like. So the components.
The components
of the electric field density of the electric field density we have E R from radial component being the same as minus Kali V by Kali R and bracket that our ER equal to A squared over R minus R E naught cos phi. And the radial component, I mean the angular component, E phi, would equal to minus 1 over R. This is current from the identities which I shared with you, and this would imply that our E phi is equal to A squared over R squared minus 1 E naught sine phi. And EZ, whereas EZ would be equal to minus Kali V by Kali Z equaling to 0 because we are not having any variation along the Z. We can draw this dumb thing and see how it varies after you have placed this cylinder in this field. Yes.
Where have you got the negative?
Where have I?
Look negative.
On where?
The CR is the negative Kali by Kali R of the. But I think, should we have a negative on that?
Now, which one is your issue? Why have I dropped or shouldn't we have? Which one is your concern, basically?
CR. ER. How you got here?
Where I put my ear? Have I rubbed off my what was my V?
It was A squared over R minus R.
Was equal to?
A squared over R.
Uh-huh.
A squared over R minus R. E naught was 5.
So we want to differentiate this with respect to R. So when you differentiate, this one definitely... So I get minus, this would be minus A squared. I have R to the power minus 1. I subtract 1 and multiply by the new one or the old one? Old one. So I first take the old one. This one, and then now I have minus R squared, okay? The negative 2. And then I have this one is minus plus 1. Why am I operating from here? The other side. Because you want to. Also, I don't know why I wrote this. Because what I have in the notes is A squared over R squared plus 1. But E naught was 5. This one here is square in the north. So I don't know where I'm going to. The E5 here is okay. Here is A squared over R squared minus 1 in outside 5. I guess it should be fine enough. You are saying that I want to say, today we need our sleep like a baby, don't worry. Because tomorrow is a Wednesday, I don't have you guys, so I'll sleep very comfortably. But for now, I want to make sure that I fulfill my obligations. Okay, I guess you now Zaba and you are doing
some student nice.
But
if I is nice.
Okay, 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 okay. If I is not still nice. You want, how do we make it nice? We underline? Or put it in a box?
No.
You said that it is not yet nice, so let me try to make it nice.
If I still
it should be outside.
Okay. Let's do it. VR 5 is equal to A squared over R minus R. True?
Yes.
E naught cos
5.
E 5 is equal to minus 1 over R. Kali? By Kali 5. Fine? So I will say that E5 is equal to I say minus 1 over R into Kali by Kali 5 into A square over R minus R E naught cos 5 across. The Kali 5 can only affect here. Cos 5, but when you get cos 5, you get a minus sign. So you get this being minus 1 over R. E nu. You have A squared over R minus R. And then you multiply by
minus E nu.
Minus E naught sine 5. Cross the brackets. So I get this as being minus is cancel out. And you can just rub them off. And so I get the A squared over R squared minus 1 E naught. Does it look nice, sir? You don't have to be lazy. You have to make sure that you work through stuff to see how it is coming about. So I guess it is okay here. It looks exactly the same. Whereas the EZ would be 0. So we now have the electric field intensities, and then we can predict how it behaves. So we had a cylinder, and we are not bothered so much on the effect of the Z. This Z here, as the field is traversing through this cylinder, The Z really doesn't make much sense, because at each point this sign would always be the same, okay? It would always be at the same point, but I mean as you move from here to there. What changes is when you are just on the surface of this of the Serena, and as you enter into the Serena up to the Sena. So we have a coin here, and instead of having straight field lines, they will be in a fair way, to the extent that we shall be having, if this was our X, I wish I could have gone through the center. So this was our X, I can draw it as our X. You have some of the field lines coming like that, something you draw as if you are crazy when you are doing assignment. And of course, as we did for the spherical ball, the conducting spherical ball, we come and we got a little bit of tilt or kick, and as you move away, far away, the field lines are not interfered with. Here you are, you come, get a king, and then the other ones are not affected. We can have our field in this form. And this is our Serena of radius A. So if I say the EZ is equal to zero, there is no field E to the blackboard. That's why we're getting the EZ being zero. And that's all to do with this example. Any questions? Since today is up to lunchtime, that's why I didn't bother rushing here. But I just reach here exactly at 12 because I know there is always a madam I can interfere with. So let's do another example, but now using the Poisson equation, and we shall look at what we call a vacuum diode of electrodes, the anode and the cathode, and then look at how the electron movement, when the electrons are moving from the cathode to the anode, how they behave, how the field is created within this in-between region, and then we see how Poisson equation can be applied in pursuit of solving the potential in the vicinity of such vacuum diode. So the other example is the solution of Poisson's equation. And we take a case of a high vacuum diode. Take a case of a high vacuum diode. So assume that a high vacuum diode, is formed with cathode and anode power plates. And our power plates. By the way, before I move on, I apologize to the those of you who were eager to go. You missed a lot, but I couldn't have much that I could have done. I also felt lonely when I was there. Finally, the place, all the locals are excited. Some of them will never see maybe the importance of science, but you guys really needed this. But I was confident that you would crown up me, crowd up, and at least see the partial one in the campus, because I was told it was phenomenal too. So I believe you saw something, nevertheless. But we entered heaven for a while and came back. So I don't need to apologize since there was something taking place here. So the other parablets of infinite extent, of infinite extent, are y is equal to 0 and y equal to a, respectively, and leaving potential, and having potential v is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0 and v is equal to va and y is equal to d. I am feeling like I shouldn't interfere with your food.
Yeah.
How many pro not in any of food? Even me, I wouldn't like to enter into my lunch. I eat mara. I don't eat chicken, I don't eat fish, I don't eat meat, although I got the money. I don't eat those things. I just eat peanuts, peas, beans. And when there are some eggplants, those egg whatever, tura, yeah. I tell them, add more, add more. Fill the gap. But I don't eat chicken. How do I eat
chicken?
I don't even know what was eating before. They killed it. You eat fish. What if it ate someone's dead body in the leg? And then I also eat. And then those guys, as you are saying, when they are looking at you. So, since you are thinking, like I'm thinking that we should eat lunch, so I put this as one number of assignment.
Yes.
I'm very sure that the potential is given by actually, I don't see the reason why I should make it a number for assignment. This should be assignment 2. Offline assignment 2. When you have all of these conditions, show that the potential is given by... That's the fortunate thing God created when He created nature. It's got all the potential that, show that the current density due to these electrons, J, is given by 4/9. Epsilon naught VA to 3 over 2 into 2E over M to the half 1 over D. But if the question is so confusing, I'll upload a nicer question on Mwede. In a format that is not an example, but in a format which is an assignment. But nevertheless, almost everything is upright in that sense. Any information you want to get on here? This is the continuity of free space. VA is the potential on the anode electrode. E is the electronic charge.
Try again.
And M is the mass of electrons goes in between what is happening is that electrons are moving from the cathode attracted by the anode, and then they create an electric field in between. D is the distance of separation of the plates, of the anode plate and the cathode plate. I think we draw now. All these assignments are 1 week, so deadline handling will be on the 12th of 11, 2013. So I need my number.